and all, because that number is not there.
12,
super.
6.
6. 2. 2. 6. 6. 6. 2. 2. 2. 12. 12. 2. Okay. I see a lot of people betting on 2 and 12. So when you bet on 2 and 12, I think most of you will lose your better half, because 2 means there is only one option, that is 1, 1. So if you want the total to be 2, there is only one option out of 36. So the chances you will win is 1 out of 36, which is almost 0. I hope similarly 12 also. So the problem with us is, whenever we take decisions, we don't think. Somebody told in one B school, sir, anyway, I have not put my money, so, sir, simply I told. So that is the problem. So if you think, number 7 has the highest possibilities. 16, 25, 34, 43, 52, 61. No other number has so much possibilities. And one axis, see, this is used in your marketing strategy also. See, shares, uncertainty is there or not. You may lose money or you may win money. So one advertisement was given by Axis Bank. There was 2 dice, and many of my students came and asked me, what does it mean, sir? Then I told them, you observe the total. So total was 7. That means you get maximum benefit if you invest in Axis Bank shares. So, but as common people, we don't understand. So therefore, my dear students, whenever we take decisions as statisticians, we don't believe anything. We believe in only numbers. We may be correct or we may be wrong. That, see, I may tell, put money on 7. If that day is not good for you, you may lose. But the chances of winning is more. It doesn't mean that you will win. See, Gujarat, they predicted 109 seats for BJP. If you go to poll of polls, from today you start observing, because every day there is a survey. Today also I was reading the newspaper, Jandan account, 10% male, or there is a gap of 10% between female Jandan accounts and male Jandan accounts. So everything is statistics now. Every day you get a survey. So we deal with numbers. Based on the numbers, we predict. Okay? Then can you tell me what is the next use of statistics or data analytics? He told decision. Can you tell me any other use of data analytics? Can you elaborate what is the meaning of problem solving? Why do you solve a problem?
In future we get some problems with decision.
Okay.
Then we can solve the problems with the help of data analytics.
No, make it very clear. You told future, no? Yeah. Is it future problem? What is the most important use of data analytics? Most important. Why so much data analytics is popular? Can you tell me? Can you tell me what is the most important use of statistics or data analytics? No use. Simply, I have come from Bangalore, no? Anybody in the class who can tell what is the important use of statistics? Answer, no problem.
Future plans.
Future plan. So when you want to marry? See, it is not future plan, it's the estimation of future. See, before Gujarat elections, the actual results came, they predicted. So many channels you have seen, no, more than 7 channels predicted who is going to win. So the important aim of data analytics is prediction. So that is called predictive model. So predictive model involves in estimating the future. Next. I hope you are enjoying. Yes or no? If it is no, also no problem. Can you tell me what is the next use of statistics or data analytics? Huh? What is the population of India today? What is the population of India? I hope you know that. Okay, around 130 crores. That is 2017, January 7th. What was the population maybe in 1940? What was the population? How much? 200 crores. Very good. Okay, around 40 crores it was in 1940. Now go back home and think about the statistical data. This is also one of the important use of data analytics. This is gives you an idea about past behavior. So this is a very serious question. You should go back home and think. Forget statistics, forget everything, forget all your problems. Think of India. See, 1940 the population was around 40 crores. In 2018 it is 130 crores. So almost three times of the population what we had in 1940. So to be honest with you, my dear students, you took 1940 years after Christ to reach a population of 40 crores. And if you take Hindu mythology, it goes to 5000 years. So whatever we achieved in 5000 years, to make it three times, we have taken only 77 years approximately. So this is the rate of growth of population. And you can imagine, I need not tell you anything. So this is all about statistics. Understood? Then what else? What is the share price index today? I hope any finance specialization students are there. Anybody? Share price index, Bombay Stock Exchange. Anybody? You don't read newspapers. Anybody, what is the share price index, Sensex index of Bombay Stock Exchange today? Very good.
Around
36,000. 34,000, it has touched 34,000 two days back. And my dear students, what did you understand by this 34,000? Every day it comes in paper, every day comes in TV. See, this is not examination, my dear students. You come out of the box. You go to exam, write the exams, you get 100 out of 100. If somebody comes and asks you, what is Sensex 34,000 mean to you, if you are a finance specialization student, anybody in the class, what does it mean, 34,000? Any finance specialization students, first sem MBA students? So this is the difference between theory and practicals. See, 34,000 means the current year is compared to a base year, that is 1979. That's why that number is huge. So any number which is more than 100 in index indicates an increase. Anything less than 100, it says it decreases. So the number is very huge because 2018 is compared with 1979. Go back to Google search, go to Bombay Stock Exchange, you get everything. In fact, you can know how that number is arrived. They use weighted averages. I hope you have studied average. They go for weighted average. 30 companies are included, top companies of India. Go, everything is there. So anything more than 100, so 100 rupees worth of stocks in 1979 has become 34,000 today, because the number is very huge, because the comparison is for almost 37 years, not even 30, almost 37, 38 years. So these are the uses of data analytics, and if you want to be, have a career with data analytics, my dear students, be serious, understand, think beyond the class, think beyond examinations, that 3 hours examinations, nowhere is there except in India. So unless you learn practically what is statistics or your subject also, see, whenever I go to rural places and say you do chartered accountancy, they were afraid. Hey, how can I do, sir? Only requirement for CA or data analytics is hard work. You should be ready to work for 24 hours. And that hunger should be there. Yes, I want to learn. Sir has come from Bangalore. I should learn something. Because last bench, any day you can sit. And that last bench will go in your life after 1 year. It will not come back. So my aim is to give this foundation course to the students, especially rural students, because Bangalore, their stomach is already full for with other things. So if I teach them statistics, they will not understand. So I have got a lot of respect for the students, especially I was very happy because the person who dropped me was your MBA student. So in Bangalore, if you tell that, they will never do. They will not come only for the fest. So I'm really happy because one student served me tea. So this humbleness will not get you a job. So you're all humble. Knowledge, that hunger, yes, I want to learn. So I hope I have made certain basic concepts very clear. Next, I'll go to next line. See, the descriptive analysis means, analytic means, by looking at something. See, by looking at the poster of a movie, you decide whether the movie is good or not. So descriptive means, by looking, you understand something. So I've taken a real life example, and some examples I've given. Most shoppers turn towards the right side when they enter the store. So this was a survey conducted on retail stores. This is a real life survey. So many of them, when they enter, they go to right side of the entrance. So therefore, they kept all costly products on the right side. So these are the strategies that you should use nowadays. Otherwise, nobody will accept you. No, I've got first rank in my MBA. See the second example, married men who kiss their wife before going to work live longer. This is also a survey. And earn more profit and less accidents when compared to, and this is a reality also. See, if I am good with my wife, I can be good with my students also. I hope all of you agree. Men are more reluctant to use coupons as compared to women. See, these are all marketing strategies. So marketing, I have taken specialization marketing, sir, I don't need data analytics, sorry. You require. So if you give more coupons to females, they'll come back. That is what the survey says. And again, it is based on survey. Okay? We can't argue because it's a general public opinion. Okay? Next line. This is a graph related to, for example, your class. So this is the graph you have got for your class, where x-axis represents your percentage you got in degree. And Y represents number of students. By looking at this graph, which you have already done in BU, PUC, degree, MBA, what did you understand by this curve when you look at this curve? What decision you can give? Suppose this curve is drawn here for your class. X-axis represents the mark score or grades, whatever percentage. Y-axis represents the number of students. What you can make an idea by looking at this graph. By looking at the graph, what idea you can make? See, when movie advertisement is given, no. When you see a lot of advertisements, oh, you think this movie is good or bad, something like that. So by looking at this diagram, what you can conclude about your class? Very bad. It's a good answer. Give him a big hand, please. Because you can observe, most of the students are in the group 50 to 60 or 60 to 70. And I hope your minimum marks for entering MBA is 50%. So don't say 60, sir, I got first class. No. You are 10% above the eligibility. Go to the next slide, please. What you can tell about this graph? When you look at this graph, what you can tell? Average, very good. It's a normal class. Neither intelligent nor dull, enjoy. It's called a normal curve, and we assume everything to be normal in life, though it is abnormal. Okay, life should go on, no? So this, if you get a graph like this, we assume that your class is normal. So I am safe, okay? So this you can see, the last part is crowded. That is, end is 80 to 90, 90 to 100. That means most of them in the group, 80 to 100. This is how the IIM seats are allocated. So if you want to join IIM, you should go to the last part of the curve if you want a seat. That is 99.73% where it was stopped last year. And now I think it will stop at 100% percentile. So this is a very intelligent class. So I can prepare my class and come. Before coming to class, if I have this data of your class, whether your class is a below average class, or extraordinary class, I can prepare my lecture. This is what all about data analytics. So simply if I come, and if you are intelligent than me, then gone case, no. Average class means, okay, chalta hai. If I tell today Sunday, you'll say, okay, sir, today Sunday, no problem. Today is Sunday only, no? Okay. Understood. So data will make you intelligent. So before coming to class, I can analyze. So I could not meet you before coming to class, otherwise I would have done a survey. And I, 2-3 students I inquired yesterday, actually, how many software you have learnt in statistics? What is that you have learnt? So based on the answer, I got an idea. You are not exposed to softwares in statistics. I'll come to the last when I conclude my session. Next is predictive analysis. This is one of the important tools used in statistics. See, we estimate the future. We estimate the future population of India. We estimate the future business. We have exit polls where we predict which party is going to win how many seats. You will not believe how many data analytics are working on exit polls. You will not believe that Sea Water organization, shortly I am going to get associated with them, they have a huge demand for data analytics because people are not there who know statistics. So take this as a career. You have a bright future and it's really interesting because we play with numbers. So these are the examples where we predict what is the future. Suppose you want to predict whether a movie will be hit or not. Suppose a customer, you want to know whether he will buy a product or not. That is called logistic regression. In logistic, the dependent variable will be categorical. So buying the product, non-buying a product is a qualitative characteristic. See, all these basic fundas, if you learn, data analytics becomes very easy because you have the knowledge of technology. The only part that you remember, lack is concepts. Once if you are strong in your concepts, nobody can beat you. Over a press of a button, you will get everything. Now I'll show now. You have 10,000 numbers, one button will give you complete statistics summary. But you should know what it is. What does it mean? So if you don't know that, then statistics can be misused. Okay? So this is called predictive modeling. And the last one is prescriptive analysis. This is the advanced analytics. It is mainly into operations research, which started after Second World War. So the name operations research was given in Second World War by British people. They called all mathematicians and statisticians to have strategies for the war. So strategies for war is not like building metro, where you take 5, 6, 10 years or you may not complete. So war means time is very, very less. So there we went, they studied maximization problems. So here I have a case study where Coca-Cola used prescriptive analysis, the model building. This is very much advanced. If you are really good in maths, and this is the last part of analytics, if you do this, then sky is the limit. For this, you should have that interest. Forget whether you know mathematics or not, but you should have that hunger, I want to learn. So this is done by IIM for 1 year. Do you know what is the cost? It is 6 lakhs. And that also you will not get seat. So this prospective analysis, we can come and teach here. Only this one is, I don't have that IIM background. But at the end of the day, you want concepts. So my dear students, think beyond Mangalore and think beyond your class. So these are the next slide. See, first one is descriptive analytics, which is basics. Next, we go for predictive analytics, which is the second one, and prescriptive analytics is the last one, advanced. We deal with a lot of linear programming problems, integer programming problems, Markov chain. See, Markov chain is a stochastic model where if you are using Colgate toothpaste, what is the probability that you will retain your Colgate toothpaste next month also? It is also called brand switch matrix. Suppose in the last elections I voted for Congress, I means, what are the chances I will vote for Congress? I only, I'll be loyal to Congress. I hope you'll enjoy in the days to come. These are the things you should learn. So when you learn all these things, it's very easy, I'm telling you, once if you are very good in your concept. Okay? So these are the three stages which we want to start in association with IIM Bangalore. That is first one, level one, that is descriptive analysis, analytics. Second one is predictive analytics. And third one is prescriptive analysis, where it's advanced. Okay? Next slide, please. See, these are the various models that you come across, all real life studies, regression, logistic regression, decision trees. As he told, the first important decision you should take when you get up from the bed tomorrow, whether to attend the class or not. So any student or any teacher, the first decision they should take is whether to attend the class or not. So from there, decision tree starts. All are very, very interesting chapters with real life case studies. Not like your Bangalore University syllabus. It is beyond syllabus, and mainly it is designed to see that corporate will accept your knowledge. That is very important in life. Okay. Linear programming is also advanced analytics. Okay. Next slide, please. Integer programming, multi-criteria decision-making model. See, multi-criteria means you'll have multiple goals in life. So whenever you have multiple goals, things are not easy. If you have one goal only, it is tough. If you have multiple goals, then it is still tough. Okay? Then we have combinatorial optimization, non-linear programming problem, Six Sigma, social media analytics. I hope you are all aware with social media, Facebook, WhatsApp, and whatnot, I don't know. But anyway, see, these are the important models we want to cover in these three courses with practical applications. So I'll go for a practical application now and solve it using SPSS. See, there are two important programs for studying statistics. One is SPSS, which is very easy. And R programming, you should have a little bit of computer knowledge, programming knowledge. That is also easy. So based on this, you will learn data analytics, not through calculators or something like that. Because if 10,000 applications are there, you can't use your calculator. So we'll try to teach you SPSS and R programming. So R is very much needed in the corporate nowadays. Otherwise, SPSS is okay for research. So next is one real life example. I'll tell you that and I'll wind up. And if any questions and answers are there, you can ask if you have understood something. Otherwise, God bless you. Maruti Suzuki, I hope all of you know, it has collected 18 years data. It's a real life study. Two columns are there. Variable one, I hope you can see. What is variable one? What is variable one? Sales, correct? What is variable two? Advertisement, sure? So variable one is sales, variable two is advertisement. So which is the dependent variable and which is the independent variable? Sales is? Dependent or independent? Sure. Super. Sales is dependent. First you should understand that. See, time is independent because it's 2 o'clock, therefore I have come. Not that I have come, therefore it is 2 o'clock. It's not like that. Time will not wait for anybody. So variable one is sales. And advertisement expenditure is the dependent variable. They have collected data for 18 years. My dear students, SPSS program or R programming want two columns. If you feed the two columns into the SPSS software, you will get the answer. After that, what it is, very important. So please, next slide. So the complete results are achieved through SPSS. Can anyone understand this table? Tare Zameen Pe. Anybody who can explain? Can anyone explain this table? Students, have you worked on SPSS? See, that problem I have fed into the computer has given these results. Can you explain? Anybody? You want to explain or take photo? Okay, I'll explain. I thought if some student explain, I'll be very happy and proud. Okay, so dependent variable is one. As all of you agreed, so sales is dependent on whatever you do in life. Can you tell me what is this 0.899? It is the correlation between sales and advertisement. What is the relationship? So 0.89 means we have a very high degree of positive correlation. So here there is no negative. There is a high degree of positive correlation. Next is adjusted R square, or R square is the effect of independent variable on the dependent variable. How much sales depends on advertisement? So 89% of the, or 80% of the variation depends on advertisement. See, 80% sales of Maruti depends on how much you care for advertisement. See, this is the regression model. See, regression means you have regressed sales on advertisement. You want to know whether that advertisement is significant or not. Whether really advertisement has an effect on sales. That is what you want to find statistically. So this is the p-value. So if p-value is less than 5%, whatever variable is there, no, it is very significant on the independent variable. So advertisement has a lot of significance on sales. You can't ignore advertisement. So that's what it means. So this p-value, actually this is 4-star. It is 0. So 0 means high level of significance. You can't ignore advertisement. So therefore, you go for advertisement is effective in sales. So it has a positive effect on sales. I hope all of you have understood. So if p-value is more, suppose if p is 0.2, then you can ignore advertisement. Because no significance. So it will not affect sales. Suppose if your p-value is 0.2 or 0.3 or 0.4. So these are the concepts if you learn, then really you can do very good model building. See, model building is not so easy. Because just you got two numbers, if you estimate, it will not be a valid estimate. See, a lot of things you should go to in your mind before you estimate. That's why I keep on telling statistics can be misused. Suppose instead of this, if I put the heights of Australians and Indians, heights of 10 Australians and heights of 10 Indians, suppose if you get R as 0.8, so 80% of change in height depends on Australians, we can't say. Because there is no relationship between Australians and Indians. So first of all, the model does not fit the data. So you can't estimate the height of Indian by putting a height of an Australian. So this is the problem with statistics. So understand the concepts. I hope you have understood this table. So here P, if it is more, you say the variable is not significant. Advertisement is not significant in sales. So since P value is less, you go for significance. Next slide. See, this is the model. See, this is, can you tell me what is the meaning of this 37,769 millions of rupees? Can anyone tell what does it mean? See, this is the model. 37,769 plus 51.22. What does 37,769 mean here? Anybody? See, it means if you don't put any money on advertisement, suppose zero is your money on advertisement, still you will get a sales of 37,769 millions of rupees if your advertisement expenditure is zero. That is the slope. Y intercept, I don't have a marker and a pen board, I would have shown you what is that. So when x axis is zero, still you have a sales of 37,769 millions of rupees. Suppose if you put 4,000 millions of rupees on advertisement, see, for every million you put, your sales increases by 51.22 millions of rupees. That's what it means, it's the slope of the line. So as x increases, y increases at the rate of 51.22 millions for every million you spend. So if you spend 4,000 millions of rupees, 4,000 into 51.22 plus without advertisements, you'll have a sales of 37,769. The total will be 2,42,649 millions of rupees when your advertisement is, expenditure is 4,000 millions of rupees. But validation of this model is very important, because before you say it's a good estimate, lot of tests we should conduct. So since it's an introduction class, I'm not going in detail. So this is how you estimate in two variables. So now, see, I've increased the independent variables. So when you increase the independent variables, what happens? The correlation becomes more. See, as I told you, heights of Indians, heights of Australians, you include heights of Africans also, you have heights of one more country, then what happens? Correlation will increase. So simply increasing the number of variables will not lead to good estimation. So this is called multiple regression, where variable one is the dependent and you have three variables. So if I feed it to the computer SPSS, you'll get the answers. Next slide. See, this is the correlation matrix. I'll not go in detail because I don't have time. See, when you have correlation between independent variables, then the situation becomes still worse. Suppose if there is a relation between marketing expenses and advertisement, positive correlation, then your model becomes vibrant. So I'll not go in detail. Next slide. See, this is the constant. That is, if you don't invest anything on 2, 3, 4, see, 2 is the advertisement expenditure, 3 is the marketing expenses, and third one is the distributional expenses. So you have, for a variable 3, you have a negative slope. That is minus 21.745 millions of rupees. So this negative indicates there is negative correlation between sales and marketing expenses. So according to this data, if you spend more money on marketing expenses, your sales will come down. So more marketing expenses, negative slope means you'll have less sales. And again, you can observe p values. Here 0.008, 0.00, 0.00, all the three independent variables are significant. So sales depends on advertisement, sales depends on marketing expenses, sales depends on distributional expenses, because the three variables I have defined as marketing expenses, distributional expenses, and advertisement expenses, and sales was the dependent variable. So here p values are less than 0.05, except for this one. See, 0.24, it is more than 5%. Therefore, whatever you have value you have got now here, it is of not that significant. So what the model is telling, if you don't invest on anything, you'll have a sales of 9,350 millions of rupees. It is not significant. It cannot be accepted because your P value is more. So that number will not be given high significance because your p value is more. Okay, so multiple regression and simple regression I have covered. So these are the problems that you'll face when you validate a model. So you can build any model. How much validation you do, that is very important. So I hope in 1 hour, whatever I wanted to tell you, I've told. I hope you enjoyed my session. So go in detail to data analytics, my request today. I think it should be an inspirational talk. Go back home. and understand statistics and data analytics. In another 1 year, it has got a lot of scope, and it's the most wanted subject now. Because when you go abroad now, people ask me, I've done your statistics, why you are still in India? So that is the demand for statistics, especially in Western countries. So think beyond the box. I hope you have enjoyed my class. If you have any doubts, clarification, you are free to ask.
Students, please feel free to ask questions and make best use of this opportunity. You may not get such eminent personality again.
Please, I don't know about that, but go back home and... because why I tell you, no, eminent or those things, end of the day, after 1 hour, if you have understood me, forget statistics, and if you think, okay, sir has come and he taught something, and you have that interest, okay, today you go back and see some statistics books and what you have learned from PUC to degree. If you go back and analyze, I think you will come up in your life. That one thing you do, my dear students, start reading newspapers, go to library, Google search, unwanted searches you make, please do some valuable search from today onwards.